This podcast is presented by the Verizon Partner Network.
Hello and welcome. I'm your host, James Kent. Today, we're going to be talking all things Verizon 5G and how this technology is going to give your business more opportunities to transform from the factory floor to customer experiences. With Verizon's coverage of 5G nationwide and the unprecedented performance of ultra-wideband, the fastest 5G in the world, this is 5G built right. To provide insights and give a rich perspective on 5G is my guest today, Mike Haberman. Mike is the Vice President of Technology for Verizon. Mike, welcome to the show. How are you today?
I'm doing well. Thanks for having me on the show to talk about 5G. We certainly like to talk about it since we're spending an awful lot of time building the network right now, as I'm sure you've seen and heard. So.
Yeah, I mean, Mike, there's a lot to talk about with 5G. But with that talk, there's a lot of confusion on what it is exactly, what it can do, what can you use it for, and what you need to know about successful deployment. So why don't we start there with a quick overview of what 5G or the fifth generation is and the major differences and advantages from 4G, which is the fourth generation.
Right. It's certainly a great place to start. So really what you're asking is defining what 5G is. And when we design the system, so it really that really is the genesis of 5G, because it captures what we're really trying to do with 5G when we built it. And there's really three main elements of 5G itself, if I just keep on that technology. The first one is to obviously increase the throughput, right? I mean, we want to have faster connections to be available in more areas. So we want to increase the throughput that customers can get because that allows more applications and things to use the network. So that's the first thing that was out there. And then the second thing that people are going to learn more about is the latency, which is, you know, how much does it lag? You know, what's the end-to-end delay in the information because that allows more real-time applications to be used. So we use the term latency. So the 5G system was designed in a way when we built it as engineers to have lower latency. So it enabled the information to get from point A to point B quicker, not through just throughput, but also just how long it physically takes to transverse the air interface part of the network. And then the third one is with any wireless technology, it's also to increase the capacity, right? In terms of how many users can handle by being built in a way that you could allow higher bandwidths or in the case of 5G, true 5G, higher frequencies to be able to use where more bandwidth is available. So the way I think of bandwidth, James, is really it's the number of lanes available on the highway. You know, if LTE has two lanes available to it, ultra wideband has 30 lanes available to it. So it's just, you know, a lot more capability.
Well, I think this higher frequencies is a great place to jump into next because while higher frequencies have these advantages, one of the challenges, my understanding, is the range is shorter. And with that in mind, what do businesses need to know to actually take advantage of 5G? And what type of infrastructure do they need to put in place? And how can Verizon help with that?
Right. So you mentioned the higher frequencies. Some view it as a disadvantage. Some see it as an advantage. I, as an RF engineer, see it as an advantage because you can control where the RF goes a lot tighter. So as you're going to see, you know, now and going forward is we could be very precise where we're trying to deploy it. So, for example, for a business, if you're putting in a private 5G system in your building, you can really do a good job of where it's propagating in your building, who you're trying to serve, where the users are. So you can make sure you design a very effective system. On millimeter wave, which again, private 5G is certainly an enabler of that. But as far as the customer end equipment, ultra wideband or our millimeter wave technology is available in all our newer devices, most all of our newer devices. So you can experience the benefit by the devices that are out there right now. And then, of course, businesses will be able to take advantage of it on the fixed wireless side. So instead of perhaps having, you know, to run a piece of fiber into your location, you can use fixed wireless, and we'll have devices that can take advantage of that. So from a business perspective, you know, the devices itself are available now, and then these private 5G networks are starting to become available now as well, where we can enhance the coverage inside your location. So that's the different angles of taking advantage of ultra wideband in your location.
Okay, now you've just mentioned ultra wideband. So Verizon has 5G ultra wideband, but what is that, and how is it better or different from, say, standard 5G? So when people hear ultra wideband, what does that mean?
Right. I mean, when 5G was designed, it was designed to work at higher frequencies, right? And part of it is because we can apply antenna technology, because, you know, higher frequencies has really short wavelength, which really translates into really small antennas. So your antenna technology really allows you to increase capacity, increase throughput, and really have what I'll call a true 5G system. So the ones that are out there right now, there are various flavors of it. You've seen the various carriers. Some have called their 4G technology 5G, right? We've seen that, and they produce maps that says, well, we got, you know, 5G in all these areas. And then the question is, well, what real 5G is that? Well, you know, just staying on Verizon, I mean, we believe in true 5G, which is the higher frequencies, certainly millimeter wave being part of it. And the reason why we say that is it provides a true game changer experience. Because when you can get speeds, you know, gigabit plus, which you can go out, for example, in big markets like New York City, which I was there, you know, yesterday, and you can get, you know, 1.8 gigabits per second on your smartphone, which is really impressive. So those are sort of fiber speeds that you can get over a wireless link on your phone. So when you think of millimeter wave, or in our case, ultra wideband, that's a true game-changing experience, which is why we talk about that technology and using that in our network. So our 5G is true 5G because it truly gives that speed, latency, and also the capacity out there as well. So, you know, so that's what we're using. You know, we are, as you've probably seen in the recent auction, we did get a large chunk of C-band spectrum, which will be able to provide a lot of the same characteristics of our millimeter wave, just at a slightly lower frequency that provides very good coverage.
So with 5G, why does it matter for businesses? How will it change business capabilities for organizations?
When I think of that question, because I certainly talk to a lot of businesses, I mean, the first thing that comes to mind is it enables real-time applications where, you know, you can do things in real time that you couldn't in wireless before, which, you know, you can think of AR, VR, you can think of, I can bring my experts into the equation locally without having them have to be there. So I can effectively deploy my resource, which allows you to approach sort of that fourth industrial revolution, where we can kind of take our productivity to another level, where people can really troubleshoot, they can see what's going on, they can provide customer experience from a distant location, which, you know, with what's going on with COVID, certainly brings on a lot more things that come to mind that allow businesses to become much more efficient. So when I think of 5G, I think of real-time applications. I think of the ability to continue to define the customer experience and segregate, or what's called network, slice the network in more ways to be able to really fine-tune for customers' applications to make sure they're getting service levels that they need for their applications work, as opposed to one size fits all. So I think it'll do that for businesses. 5G provides additional security for customers as well. And then, of course, you know, the private networks that we talked about earlier. So that's where 5G, when you think of those applications and how you use it really will start to come into crystal clear view on what it can do for business.
Obviously, 5G capabilities will have an impact on the tech side of business organizations, but how will it benefit, say, sales, marketing, and other aspects of businesses in different industries?
Yeah, I see that as going back to the last point. I mean, if I'm in the sales end of things, I want to be able to work anywhere, right? I want to be able to download anything, whether it's a video file, whether it's a large file. I want to be able to bring expertise and bring them into my location. So I see it as helping that group out to be able to bring in the resource that needs to really close deals wherever you are, get the information you need right where you are. So it enables that sort of real-time ability to bring the assets of your office to wherever it is you are to be able to really better your business. So to me, it certainly helps the technical side out. It helps the sales side. Same thing with marketing. It's wherever you are. So it allows us to collaborate and bring all these things together in real time, right? Which I think is a game changer. Think of AR, VR. With low latency, which is really a requirement for those types of applications, which LTE is on the hairy edge of. 5G gets you all the way there.
Now, are there any interesting 5G projects or examples of 5G in action that you can share? I mean, I know we're still in the early stages of 5G deployment, but I'd love to hear how some businesses are already taking advantage of Verizon 5G ultra wideband capabilities.
Yeah, I you're seeing the basics put in place right now, James, where, you know, most of the phones that we're selling right now are millimeter wave able right now. And by the way, you know, a large share of them are C-band capable, that spectrum that I asked earlier, which is, you know, a part of ultra wideband as well. When you think about that, you know, customers are using them right now to basically take their work location further out into the, you know, into the environment to be able to use that. So that's the first and foremost. And then secondly, you know, fixed wireless access. You know, that's an application that really is starting to come into play in our ability to serve that because of the bandwidths, the reach of the network that we've never had before. So I see that on the business side as well. So you're seeing a lot of the fundamentals come into play, which is, you know, the platforms are there. And then the applications on top are, you know, will clearly continue to follow. And you can see, you know, examples of those like autonomous vehicles and that sort of things that can take advantage of powerful networks that have super low latency out there.
Absolutely. Mike, there's a ton of exciting stuff, I feel, on the way with 5G. And on this show, we'll be tackling a wide range of topics related to 5G, including other Verizon nationwide and edge solutions. But for this episode, anything else you'd like to share about our conversation on 5G and ultra wideband capabilities?
Yeah, I mean, there's one thing that comes to mind is when I think of wireless carriers. What we're talking about certainly is 5G, and others will follow, right? I mean, they'll do their part. But one thing that makes Verizon unique is the fact that, you know, we have spectrum at millimeter wave. We have by far more than any other carrier. We made a huge investment in C-band, right, which allows you to get a nice blend of more spectrum, right, at pretty good propagation. We certainly have the low band frequency that provides nice coverage. You couple that with the fiber assets that we have, you know, not only in the original Verizon footprint that we're also building outside the Verizon footprint. And then you bring that virtual core, which enables you to bring functionality out to the edge of the network, which again reduces latency, and obviously you need to have fiber in place. So you put those elements together of spectrum, fiber, the fact that we built a virtual core, and you're building a network that really others can't follow because they don't have all those assets in place. We've been investing in this over the past 5 or 6 years, in addition to the spectrum we just purchased. So it uniquely positions ourselves to satisfy customers in the way that other carriers don't. So you're going to see great reliability. You're going to see award-winning performance on our network, right? And obviously everything else that goes with Verizon, including security and all those sorts of things that we've historically provided and we will continue to do. We're certainly a leading provider there. So I think of the uniqueness of our position and the assets that we've really put together over the last 5 or 6 years.
Oh, man, this is very exciting stuff. I really want to thank my guest today, Mike Haberman, Vice President of Technology for Verizon. Mike, if folks want to learn more about all the ways to unlock business possibilities with Verizon 5G, where's the best place for them to start?
Certainly you can go to our website, verizon.com, available, and you can search all the great things that we provide. There's a lot of information on our millimeter wave service and all the other services we provide, including all of our products as well. So, a lot of information to go through there.
Mike Haberman, I appreciate your time.
All right. Thanks for having me, James.
And thank you for watching this episode today. As I mentioned, we have more shows with amazing guests and content coming up, so be on the lookout for those. But until then, this is your host, James Kent, reminding you that if your business deserves more, Verizon delivers. Let's talk again soon.